this whole business where you're claiming one person's the baby daddy when they're not. Like, you slept with two guys within the space of 2 hours. I could be expecting that person.
They're always gonna tell you that you cannot do it. But tell them, no, I can't. Look at me now, baby. I'm doing it. I did it. I'm still gonna do it till I die, baby.
Give me Mungandidi, Mungandidi, go.
Hey guys, hi, welcome back to my YouTube channel. I know it's been a while. I was meant to be doing Vlogmas and then it kind of never turned out to happen because it's difficult, okay? Like, let's not even try and lie about this. It is difficult uploading a video every single day for 25 days. No. But I know it's a bit too early because Christmas hasn't happened yet, but like, Christmas is gonna happen in a few days, so we might as well like get the ball rolling on this because like, I got a few bits. The first thing, we are leaving in 2019, okay? Open your ears. If you didn't know, Grace Angelore is pregnant. She's due sometime soon. So all those people, all of those people that were busy screaming men are trash, whatever, it's a movement. I know I was part of them, okay? I understand I was part of them, but like, that was all purely just emotional displacement, and I'd like to apologize to all the people that I attacked saying that men are trash, even though it's more to do, you need to redirect your emotions to the person that hurt you, not to the whole species, of which the whole species as a collective, they have their own issues, but anyways, that's beside the point. We also have our own issues, but that's beside the point. So all of those people that were busy screaming men are trash with Grace, Grace is pregnant. So what were you doing in your life? You were listening to Grace screaming, Lalil! You were busy doing like Wakanda forever with Grace. You're like, meth. Grace is pregnant. Grace is enjoying her life with a boyfriend, with a man. What have you been doing, sis? And now you're just there saying that like, I'm laughing because like, this is an absolute joke, because like, some of you take the things that most of your favorite influencers put out there as Bible, and it's like, sis, like, do you know how much stuff you don't see? Like, the amount of stuff, okay, let's say per video that you see, right, you don't know how much editing has gone into that, the amount of stuff that's been cut down and removed from that video, and you're taking everything that she said as it is. And also, you don't see Grace, you don't live with her, you don't see her day to day, you don't know what she's doing. Yes, she's funny, don't get me wrong, like, I still watch her videos and I still be kicking, and when I saw the post when she was pregnant, I was like, yeah, sis, get you that baby, okay, that baby batter, you're making some babies, cool. But then after I started thinking, I was like, wait, what about all those women that are rallying behind her saying that men are trash and screaming this, that? Anyways, I have nothing else to say in this situation apart from I'd just like to formally make a PSA announcement and apologize to all the people, because like, I had a whole thing where before I would actually like, so the bins where I live, right, the bins get collected on like Wednesday, that's irrelevant. Anyways, whenever the bins were collected, I would just record it on my Snapchat and post it and be like, one way ticket for all men. Particularly Zimmen, but anyways, actually, but now it's like Zimmen, Nigerian men. Oh, anyways, next thing we're leaving is, while we're still on this topic of like people and like rallying behind and whatnot, and about people and their men and whatnot. So, sis, come close, like, just come. So we need to stop calling and claiming people our man when you're just fucking, like, if you have your genitals and the other person has their genitals and they're just stimulating each other constantly, periodically, weekly, monthly, 3 times a day, Lord knows, I don't know how many times you do it, it's not your man. If all you do is just stimulate each other's genitals, it's not your man. Okay, stop, sis. Like, just stop. This is how you all get caught up in your feelings and get hurt and you'll be like, ah, my man, my... I'm like, no. No, no, no. Oh, no, 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 no. stop, sis. Just stop. This is how you get hurt. This is how all of you be busy crying. Cuffing season, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, it's cold. That's why these people are hitting you up left, right, and center and saying that, oh, where are you? What are you doing? It's cold. Okay? It is cold outside. Okay? In the UK, it is freezing cold. That's why you have this person hitting you up so frequently, because they just want to find a way to make you keep them warm. And while you're at this, all of you are busy keeping each other warm. Can you please go get checked? Because like this business of keeping, like, you're exchanging bodily fluids and bodily fluid sounds and whatever else you want to exchange, but then some of you don't even know the last time you got checked. But who am I to say? They're not my genitals. I know where my genitals have been. So while we're on this whole, identity crisis, can we leave the whole expectation of that, oh, because a guy has a dick, they should have condoms? I know someone watching this has been doing this for time. Like, can you stop? Like, stop it. Like, listen, stop expecting guys to have condoms. They are not the one that will get pregnant. Okay, they're not the one that will get pregnant. Okay, so stop expecting guys, just because they have a dick, it doesn't mean that they are going to have condoms on them. Most of them try and use that as an excuse. They don't carry them, so that if you don't have them, they'll just be like, oh well, 9 months later you got a baby. Oh well, now you're tied to that person for the rest of your life, because you're gonna be seeing them and be doing like co-parenting with them and shit, and their morals are fucked up, and Lord knows you don't even know, and they end up. Stop. Let's leave this energy in 2019, okay? Like, allow it. Just leave it, okay? Just a bit. Leave it, okay? Let it go. Remove. You can see most of my stuff is all related to people's genitals, because, like, that's what mostly my channel is about. But anyways, whatever. Another thing. Can we stop? Like, listen, I thought this was, like, stopped. Like, I had been hopeful that it had stopped about a couple of years ago. I mean, like 2017, 2016. Can we stop, like, denying our kids? Like, stop requesting a paternity test for a child that clearly looks like you. Also, stop doing this whole business where you're claiming one person the baby daddy when they're not. Like, you slept with two guys within the space of 2 hours. I could be expecting that person, okay, your boyfriend, your said to be boyfriend, is the one that's the baby daddy, but then you slept with another guy 2 hours before you slept with your boyfriend. Oh, anyways, I'm gonna leave that one as it is, but can we stop? Okay, like, it's just disgusting. I'm sorry, it's a bit like disrespectful on yourself. Like, have some like morals, have some standards, but anyway, who am I to say? Next one is more pertaining to friends.
Hey, you, I need you to smell me.
What? I'm not smelling your pit.
Come on, man. I gotta know if I stink.
Fine. Passable. Okay, so we're best friends now, because I didn't just do that for nothing.
Okay.
If you saw my previous video, I was talking about how there's like abuse. We're doing like, we have a series going on here called Toxic Relationships, okay? We will revisit that in the new years. And like I said, the next one I'll be coming is Toxic Relationships with your extended families. Just spend some time with them, enjoy Christmas, and we'll talk about them after. But anyway, so, can you stop calling everyone your friend when they're an acquaintance? Like, please, I swear this should have been like left in 2007. Like, you should, stop calling everyone your friend. Not everyone is your friend. They are not your friend. If you met someone through your friend, right? Okay, if you met someone through your actual friend, they're not your friend automatically. They, like, that word is thrown around left, right, and center as if it means nothing. But then when you get into shit and then you start looking and you're like, is this something a friend would do to you? No, baby girl. No, I don't think so, sis. I don't think so. If it's your friend, they would know. And then they know what kind of things that you expect from them and like what you find respectful and disrespectful. So stop calling everybody your friend. I know some of you are very scared to be lonely, of which, to be fair, if you fear being lonely that much and don't want to be lonely, you definitely should be, because you got a lot of work to do on yourself, because that doesn't make sense. You can't be busy being around, like, it's very dangerous if your mindset is all about, oh, I need to be around people because this and that. You don't enjoy your own company. That is a dangerous mentality to have. Like, you need to fix up on yourself, because watch, like, people will show you, like, when pressure is applied, you will see the true colors of people. It's like how a diamond is made under pressure. Yeah, some people don't end up looking like a diamond. Some people will show you their true colors, and some of them, like, listen, they look like an iguana. Sorry to iguanas, but, like, that shit's ugly. So, fila trainers or any form of stack trainers, I'm sorry. And what's worse, the people that wear these filler trainers are short, and I'm like looking at you and I'm like, stupid girl, you're still short. Like, I don't understand. It's like heels, I understand, contributes towards like a more sexy posture, basically, but filler trainers, I don't understand. Like, mate, no, I don't know who decided, like, who, like, you know what, things I don't understand about companies, right? How do you all sit down, right? You come with a design, right? You all sit down. It's not even like just one person goes through this. You cut one person, okay, the designers, I don't know how many there will be within the company. They come with a design, right? It goes under scrutiny. Everyone puts in their 2 coins and whatever, 2 cents in about like what they think it should not be done to the design, whether it should be taken further or not. But fila trainers, I'm wondering how, like, long, like, please, how long did that process go to the point of from pencil to paper? From that paper to it being scanned through, from that scanning through to a thingy digital model of it being made, from that digital model to you testing out fabrics and everything, to you actually making a prototype and you actually trialing it out, and then you approving it for it to be sold. Please make it make sense. Like, why? Like, just like, please. Okay. So this one, this one's a combination of a bunch of different things. So, fake hair companies, right? Hold on. Fake hair companies, Instagram, particularly hair companies, need to become, they should just be like left, like, listen, I ordered, right, particularly, I wanted to do a full like hair review video on this, but then I realized that, like, listen, this company isn't worth my energy because I'm trying to get my money back from them. Actually, you know, I'll just show you one. I bought 2 different ones because I was hoping that maybe one might show up as it is. I didn't have much hopes in it, but I just wanted to, I wanted them to prove me wrong, but then they proved me right. So there's a black one, we'll just focus on the red one, okay? Yeah, some of you have been thinking, oh, Edna, why'd you spend money on wig? Listen, yeah, I didn't spend a lot of money on it. Like, for the 2 wigs, I think it costed me like £54. I have wigs, okay? I know wigs. Like, my wigs, all the wigs I have, they start from 250 and upwards. And they're actually decent wigs. So don't come at me about the whole thing of like, oh, but I'm just trying to show people, like, listen, these Instagram hair accounts, do not trust them, okay? Do not. And the thing is, what's funny, right, the company that I got the hair from, their website name has changed. Like, it's completely changed. We're trying to look them up. It's not there. It's completely different. So, let us do a comparison. This is Raspusha. Yes, she's my lovely 22-inch. Is she 22 or 24? 22 or 24-inch frontal. Raspusha, yeah, nice to meet you all. Yes, I called the Raspusha from Norbit, but anyway, of course she got a lot of attitude. So this is what human Peruvian hair looks like. Now, this is what I received in the post. So, let me put side by side. As you can see, this is hair, human hair. This plastic synthetic rubbish, I do not know. What, like, can someone, oh God, like, it does it even make sense? Like, how do you have a whole website that's dedicated towards you doing false advertisement and trying to make money out of it, and then on top of, like, it does it even make, it doesn't make sense. Okay, I'm gonna show you what a frontal looks like, right? If you did not a frontal, so you see that lace, yeah, she's a bit dirty, I haven't cleaned her up a bit, but anyways, shush. Frontal, this is what a frontal looks like, right? You got lace right here, There, you got lace all the way here. This is what a frontal looks like. On the other hand, this was advertised as a lace front. What lace is?
What?
Like, what? Where? Lace where? Where? Is this the lace? Like, lace where? Please explain to me how this is a lace front. Like, they even had it. They even thought about putting adjustable combs, because for some reason they thought that would make it better. Yeah, putting adjustable combs would dispute the fact that you put this on the website as a lace front. It is not a bloody lace front. Like, seriously. Listen, I'm just... These companies, they need to be left. Like, seriously, like, I don't understand how they feel so... How do you sleep at night when you do things like this? You started a whole company that's just fake news. Like, faker than fake. Like, what is this? Like, another one. This one even worse was meant to be full lace. Like, what lace? Like, what lace? Like, look at this. What kind of parting is this meant to be? What is this?
What was the reason?
Anyway, so based on these two, I ain't gonna pay, because the amount's gonna cost me to try and return this shit and the amount I paid for it, it's not worth it. The company that I got this hair from was Zali Hair, of which now it's changed to Sunbed or some shit like that. Like, sis, we need to cancel this, we need to stop them. Don't buy hair from any Instagram vendor, okay? Like, talking about actual people, actual hair companies where you can see the actual product itself, you can see them using it. They actually do tutorials on the Insta stories. It's a completely different story from these ones where they have these fancy videos where it will just pop up some girls who like push you, like they're white usually. They'll come and then they'll put their hair into whatever, into a wig cap, and then the next thing they pop a wig on and then it's looking all flawless and whatever. Like, shut up. There's no lace front wig that's gonna be 24, or that's gonna be more than, starting from 12 inches, that's gonna cost less than £120. Don't even try me. It's actually a frontal. Don't even try me. Like, frontal. There's no frontal that starts from 120. That's even a lie. From the people that do my wigs, most of their frontals, from the shortest one, they start mostly at 150. So don't, like, sis, no. While we're on this, to just close this all off, baby hairs. They're the most revolting thing I've ever, like, I'm sorry. If you do baby hairs, there's some that are palatable, okay? Like, a small amount. It's more a smidge amount of baby hairs that are palatable. Like, why? Why? Just why? Like, me... I have nothing else to say. Yeah, some of you might be saying that, oh, you can't say anything about baby hairs because your hair... Yeah, well, like, at least I take care of my hair. Some of you, like, your hair that's underneath your wigs been looking a hot mess. I don't know what you're doing. You spend money on wigs, but then you can't spend money to go to a salon to get your hair done. Like, make it make sense. That's pretty much all I had to share in this video. So, until next time, you know what to do. You know what to do.